Hey everyone, it's Brody with Everything Board Games. I have Lucas Weese here with his game from Cohio Games. Is that right? Cohio Games?
Cohio.
Cohio we're Games.
Yeah, we're from Columbus, Ohio. Very inventive.
Oh, name. That makes it so much easier. And you got Crab Dash that's going to be going on Kickstarter here soon. Is that right?
Yeah, we're launching tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, or January 18th Eastern, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So
probably by the time everyone's watching this, it'll already be on Kickstarter. So I'm going to put that link down here just in case, you're interested in backing this game. Lucas, tell us a little bit about it.
What it is it's a betting / racing game that emulates a crab race, a hermit crab race, which is something you see in bars, usually down south or something like that. But it's basically they throw a bunch of hermit crabs in the center of a round table, race to the edge, and people are betting on which crab is going to like finish first. So we just took that concept and tried to make it into kid-friendly / a little bit of strategy type game.
This is like a real thing that people do. Is that right?
Yeah. We've been at conventions and stuff like that and had booths, and we had our other game on there, Battle Blakes, and then we had like the prototypes and everything for Crab Dash, and oh, this looks the artwork. They were attracted to the artwork, and they come up and be like, oh, this looks interesting, and we'd be like, oh yeah, are you familiar with what a crab race is? And when people said yes, we were like, oh, okay, sweet.
I'm not familiar at all. You know, I didn't even know. So good to know.
It's more popular down in like the southern and near the coast type of things. But I was born in South Carolina, so I kind of have that. But then I've seen it at random bars.
So the Crab Dash is the same. The theme, they're crabs that are racing and you're betting on which ones are going to win. Is that essentially?
Yeah. You're rolling dice. There's three different dice. There's a 12-sider that dictates which two crabs will move. Each one has four different spots on the dice. And then there's two other dice that are directions. So one of them's mostly forward and the other one's forward or clockwise or counterclockwise. The board's circular and they start in the center and then race out to the edge. So you could have a crab moving and then just and circles around the board if the die rolls dictate that. So if you can visualize what's going on there.
Yeah, I kind of see. So does the die roll, so one of them turns it, and then does it just go straight in circles? Is that what it is, or, you know?
No, they always face the outside edge.
Okay.
But they could move over clockwise or counterclockwise, and as they get closer to the edge, it costs more to bet on them. More crabs can fit in the spaces. So at the very beginning, only one crab can fit in a space. So if you would, another crab would move into that space, would actually climb over it and move, progress a little more forward and stuff like that.
Yeah, so it's going like, say it's going towards the side of the board there, and then it could go, you know, around and then go off another side of the board. So it could go really anywhere, just like a crab might. Just go wherever.
Yeah, just wander aimlessly. Yeah, because they don't have direction. They don't know what they're supposed to be doing. So, and that's one of the things. You're betting on which crab's going to win. And then you're also, there's an alternate bet where you can bet on which, we call them lanes, like sextants, six sides. I think that's an appropriate term, not quadrants, but sextants. And you can bet on like which lane you think crabs are going to finish into, and that's a like a side bet you can do. So,
oh yeah, that makes it interesting. So you play until I think I read three of them finish. Once three of the crabs finish, then that's the end.
Yeah, and there's a you get a multiplier by your first, second, or third place. So first place, the basic one is. Second place times 7, third place times 5. So however many betting cubes or markers that you put on the crabs, that's how much you'll score as a multiplier at the end. And then the lanes are either 3 times or 2 times, depending on how you bet on the lanes.
Oh, so. Yeah. So is that how they actually do it in real life too? You know, like at the bars?
At the bars, I think it's more so they choose a crab. I think they do it different ways, but like what I've seen mostly is they like I'm crab number 5 and they're all like painted real fun painted shells and stuff like that. If you want to see some video of crab races, it's literally a site called crabrace.com. I think they say the National Crab Racing Association or something like that. But it's someplace down in Florida that you can actually see videos of live crab races.
I'll have to check that out. Now, are you doing this project with someone else?
Yeah. My co-designer on it is Matt Schaub. He and I've been friends since middle school. So, and I don't know if you can tell in the video, there's a lot of white here. I'm mid-30s. But he and I've been playing games together for pretty much our whole lives. I mean, we started playing Magic back in middle school, and then that just progressed into board games in the early 2000s and stuff like that. And yeah, we've been friends for a long time, and he helped with like the, if there's anyone that can break a game, I go to him, because he is really good at that. The original concept was kind of like a shared concept, and then we've just been working out the kinks together. It's been really fun having someone to bounce ideas off of and call me out when like that doesn't work. So
the game's been balanced, we know.
yes very much. Well, as much as a random dice rolling betting game can be balanced.
Right, exactly. Now, tell us about your art and who did your art.
Oh, the art's done by a guy named Paul May. He's a local artist that I've known for probably close to 15 years or so. He's done some like installations. He's had a booth at one of the community festival type things we have here in Columbus. He has his Facebook page is Not Good Wood, and that's because he actually can work with like he's done a lot of cool work with marionettes and stuff like that too. So, but his artwork's kind of cutesy but a little grungy type dirty artwork, and we thought that'd be really good for the crabs and making them like unique and appealing for everybody. So,
and I can see that with the art, you know, I can see that kind of. I don't know if it's a technique or whatever it is.
Like none of these are done on computer. Like these are hand drawn. He uses paint markers and stuff like that, and he spends the time and actually has a lot of fun. And I think the product he comes out with is pretty good. Some of the stuff is just like images of pictures he's taken for me, and I've just kind of transferred them. They'll be higher res when the final game comes out and everything like that, but just to get some visuals, I just took his camera photos, cropped out the extra, and like placed them on things.
This is a Kickstarter game. No one's really kind of got to put their hands on it much. Tell us about the components, and I know you get the crabs are have on little standees. You got a board. You know, explain some of that.
Right now, the board's 18x18. I want to do a 24x24 just so they have a little bit more room on the board. The crabs are on standees, similar to like a King of Tokyo or something like that. Mm-hmm. The dice are, we wanted to use like big chunky dice to make it like, the age we're going for is 8+. We've had people play with kids. Play testing with kids is fantastic with it too. But so they're like 25 millimeter, 1-inch big chunky dice, 1 12-sider, 2 6-siders for the movement. There's a deck of cards that have, you'll get cards in the beginning, and then throughout the die rolls, some of the die rolls will give you more cards. And they alter the effects of like make a crab move, make a crab not move, all this other stuff, get free bets and stuff like that. And then there's some reroll tokens that you'll earn throughout the game, which can make someone reroll a die. They're like, I don't want that crab to move, so reroll that, or I don't want that crab to move, I don't want you to get that, reroll type of thing. And then there's one of the cards will do like a spill based on a bar, like people spilling drinks on the table, stuff like that. And that's another little token, cardboard token chip that you place on the board that'll like stop movement and when a crab gets to it and stuff like that too. So
it sounds like even though there are dice in the game, there is a strategic component to it, you know, even though you don't really know what the crabs are going to do, you can manipulate them with, you know, your cards and be strategic in that way.
Yeah. Some of them will like move a crab forward. Crab in first moves backwards. Crab in last moves forward 2 spaces. We don't let any of the cards let crabs pass the finish line though, or cross the finish line, because we don't want someone to hold on to that card cross the finish line. But yeah, you can kind of mitigate the die roll a little bit with that, with the cards and with those reroll tokens. So
awesome. So what's the one thing in this game that makes it unique?
One thing would probably, I'd probably go with theme, just because it's, I don't know of any other crab racing board games. But in the board mechanic where they can move around, it's not a circular where they're moving out to the edge. They're just scattering or moving like around in a circle to get to the edge, or a spiral, I guess. They're just all over the board going everywhere. So I would say the unique thing, or the artwork. I like the artwork too, but
no, good luck going to Kickstarter here soon. You know, I'll put the link below. Hopefully we can get some people to check out this game and see what it's like.
Yeah, I'm hoping we've had a lot of good feedback from the reviewers and stuff like that, which is it's been very nice. So hopefully we get the word out and people like the game and what we're offering.
Again, this is Lucas Weese with Cohio Games, and I got it right this time.
Yeah.
Thanks for being with me.
All right. Thanks, Brody.